Hey, I need help. I need a lot of help. My brain doesn't work like it's supposed to, okay? It doesn't. I'm not stupid. I'm not an idiot. I know how to write English. I can read it pretty well. The thing is, my brain goes everywhere, so I freak out. Now I'm already freaking out even talking about this subject, and so it's very hard for me. We picked up complaints. I need the help. Filing a complaint. And then the ironic part of this is I also need help writing an apology letter to the Clintonville Police Department. And I'm turning that in the same day that I turn in my complaint, I guess. Okay, let me just forget about how I feel or anything like that about doing this. I have to do it. It's just what has to be done to, and I'll do anything for Nadia. This is for Nadia. Make no mistake about it. I need help writing an apology letter. Just somebody dictate. I mean, I'll say the things I'm saying right now. Here's the apology letter, and then I'll go to the complaint. No, I'm going to go to the complaint, and then I'll do the apology letter. So, our complaint is this, and I need help writing it. Please, somebody, help me. I need help writing it. And that's the thing. Like, they would nail me. If it was up to me to write this complaint, then nothing would ever get done. Nothing would ever get done. Or I'd get locked up for nothing. The next stop, they'd find a bag, a kilo or something, you know? I don't know. What would they find? They found nothing this time and claimed it was something. I don't know what they would do to me. I'm sure they would like me to go away. That was made apparent during the I'm not going to call that a traffic stop. That was made apparent during the gang harassment. Okay. So the complaint. The sexual assault that occurred between me and occurred by Officer Bartell, the Clintonville Police Department, against me. I told him he grabbed and squeezed the head of my penis. Now, and he said, you'd be surprised where people hide things. And then he puts a finger down the crack of my ass. That's what happened. It's on tape. That's what happened. Now, I need help filing a complaint. I need people who are above me. I don't know who. See how my brain works? Now I'm supposed to file a complaint. I need help filing a complaint. Like, okay. For this, there's a few things. One, the traffic stop was legit. I will call that a traffic stop when they pulled us over and they asked about the plates. Okay, now pulling us over, the mission of pulling us over was the plate. That's some excuse, a cookie on my face. It was delicious though. It's like this, it's kind of messy. I eat first thing in the morning, please forgive me. I ain't even had coffee yet. So, the complaint is this. Once they stop you, now the mission, they establish a mission, okay, see a car. So they establish a mission. That obviously it was no place. I mean, so, because DMV's computers were down and they gave us paper, you know. But the mission of the stop was to establish registration of the vehicle. Now that was established very, very quickly. In Rodriguez versus the United States, that's a Supreme Court case, and there's cases that stem off that, but of course I don't have LexisNexis. I don't have access to a lot of that. But this is what they're supposed to do. The mission of the stop, establish, you know, so whatever the stop of the vehicle for. Once that has been met, once they've been satisfied but with their mission, they're supposed to send you on your way. I don't care if there's a canine there or not. It doesn't matter if there's a dog in the car. It doesn't matter. Once they see your registration is legit, which was immediately, they shouldn't even take it to their car. Read Rodriguez versus the United States. And it's a shell of a case because it hasn't completely been, but the things that stem off of it is very interesting. So, Rodriguez versus the United States says plainly that, you know, they shouldn't even take it to their vehicle. Because at that point, you're considered under arrest. If they take your license and they take your registration papers to their vehicle, obviously no reasonable person feels like they are able to leave. So we are being detained. Now, we were detained past the point that they learned the registration was legit. Which means we should have been on our way at that moment. Instead, we were held for however many minutes. It's in the video. I don't know how long it was. We were held for many minutes past that. To, assumably, I don't know why, but assumably, to wait for the dog. Now, my other complaint is that the dog didn't smell anything, it didn't hit, and I would like to see, I don't care, they ain't gonna show me, and the police made that apparent, that I don't get to see the dog hitting, that I file a complaint and he looks, and that's what happened. So, you know, my eyes never get to view it, unless but for $20 per video, per person, I can get that stuff. However, financially, I can't do that. I don't know how many people were there. I don't know their names, so it would be $20 to find out who. It'd be $20 per video. It'd be $20 what? I mean, I don't know. I videoed enough, right? And the rest can be seen by public record search. I don't have the money. You see, this is my complaint. This would never go anywhere because I'm a mess in here. Oh, man, it's like gerbils. I need help filing this because I can't write. I can't, when I sit down to write like that, I write like I speak. Yeah, figure that out, right? So I need help. Can somebody help me? Will somebody help me? Please help me. Somebody help me. Like, this is bad. And I have to write an apology letter by Monday morning. Okay, I would like to write an apology. I need also help writing an apology letter. yeah. Okay, so the complaint is this. We were detained longer than we were supposed to be. I mean, once we handed him the papers, he shouldn't have taken that to his vehicle. And the passenger of the vehicle is of no interest to him. It's a registration. Yet I was greeted first. You know, this was because I was in the car, okay? Now, once those registration papers were given to him, we should have been on our way. That is it. He has a radio right there. He does not need to go to his vehicle. He does not need to go back to his vehicle and hold the papers, Rodriguez versus the United States, so that no reasonable person, and I tend to be reasonable on occasion, would feel like they could leave. I didn't feel like I could just get out of the car and walk away. But why couldn't I? I was a passenger. No, but no, I didn't feel like that. And she certainly didn't feel like she could drive off. He had her license and her papers. Like, of course she couldn't leave. But we were waiting for the dog, right? And that's illegal. The Supreme Court. This is a Supreme Court. So, I am going to assert that after the point that we handed him the papers, it was no longer a traffic stop. It was gang harassment. And when a gang harasses me, you see me making jokes, you see me making... That's not how I felt, though. I'm trying to keep my shit together. You know? So I have to joke. There's a lot of things in my life that I've had to crack jokes about that nobody else would laugh at. Anyway, I need help. The complaint would be, okay, I've gotten as far in 10.5 minutes. I have gotten as far as we handed them the papers and they kept us. This is why I can't do it. I'm on disability, if that helps anybody. I don't know if there's anybody that can help. Jesus. Okay. So then once we were taken out of the... You know, once they brought the dog and they said the dog hit. I'm asking the sergeant what the hit is and he will not tell me. So then I posted links. They're public on Facebook. It's like Steinig Tal or something like that. It's like where Clintonville and Marion police dogs are trained. So I looked that up, find that out. And then I went on their website. And it shows pictures, and there's a link to that. Of exactly what a dog does when it alerts on a vehicle. You don't have to be a canine handler to see the alert. You know, I mean, anybody who's there would see a dog sit down or to scratch a spot or to sit and look at it and just be like, I don't want to walk anymore. Like, this smells interesting. You know, none of that happened. But they won't clearly say in the video, like, what the alert was. He said, you know, it's very broad, vague, absolutely undefinable, a change in behavior, you know. Like, I don't... My behavior changes when I have to... Sometimes I'm anxious. My behavior changes when I have the runs. You know what I mean? I might be a little quicker to handle activities, such as smelling a vehicle. I mean, they're trying to alert very specifically so that they can use these things in court and show a jury that the dog alerted. That's the whole thing. It's an obvious signal. Okay, so... Now, they said the dog hit, it didn't. I need help writing this report to say all this stuff. The stop was too long. The dog thing was a complete farce. We were pulled out. We were searched based on the farce of the dog. Our car was torn apart. They sexually assaulted me. He grabbed, and squeezed my penis. Another man, a stranger to me, grabbed and squeezed the head of my penis. And I said so. And his response was, you'd be surprised where people hide things. I said, in the head of their penis? Is that his experience as a police officer, that he's found a lot of things in the head of people's penises? That was sexual assault, man. Ouch. Ouch. Look, it was sexual assault, right? I need this complaint. I need to help filing it. And so does my girlfriend. Because they grabbed her by the vagina. Said she's been had a history of being touched by strange men, man. I was molested as a child. There's PTSD there. You don't fucking do that. But they did. And I have to file a complaint. But I can't think in the order that I'll need to think. I can't think of the things that I'll need to think of. I'm good at research. I'll help, but I have till Monday morning. Somebody help me. Come on, man. Forward it to somebody, please. Somebody. There's got to be somebody higher than that that would just say, look, no way was that cool. Like, and then at the end, and I don't know if I'm missing things. The whole traffic stops on video. I need help, man. I have to fuck Monday. With two things. And the second thing is, yeah. And so, then at the end of the traffic stop, we are told that there's THC shake in the center console. In the center console. Now remember that that's very important. So when we go back to the vehicle, we film the center console. There's nothing of the sort. Absolutely nothing of the sort. And the chief of police said to me that they would leave that. That typically if it was just THC shake or something, they would advise somebody to go to a gas station and vacuum it out. We weren't advised that. I asked them to test it. Because I'm on parole, and I don't want to be driving in a vehicle that has THC shake in it. Because then they just left us with a vehicle that the dog would alert on again. If it ever alerted, which it didn't. They had no interest in they could. I said, was it tested? Like then I was threatened that they would make an issue out of it. And when the police make an issue for me, I go to jail. Like I'm on parole. I get put on a PO hold. I would, at that moment, I would have been put in handcuffs. So I said to them, I'm sufficiently intimidated that I'll leave. And that's the fact. I left because they intimidated me into leaving. We videoed the entire thing. We videoed the center console and we got back in. You saw me eating my macaroni and cheese in the video, and we get back in the car and there's a cigarette butt put right in the middle of it. Sending messages much, Clintonville Police Department, you know? Okay, now, fast forward, and I have to call my PO on Friday. I think this happened on Wednesday, and I have to call my PO on Friday. And, hold on, because at the end of the video, Officer, I don't know, Kaczynski, he says, there is no issue. But if I wanted the THC shake tested in a car that we just bought, then there would have been an issue. But he says there's no issue. I think THC shake in a state where THC is still illegal for whatever reason is an issue, right? I mean, okay. So I don't want to ramble. Somebody would help me. We could talk. You can watch the video. You could see. But we never should have been held that long. We never should have been sexually assaulted. They lied about the dog hitting. They lied about finding anything. And here's how I can prove that. Because when I called my PO on Friday, her report said that the THC shake was found in the passenger where I was sitting, in the passenger side floorboard. But in the video, he said it was found in the center console. Let that sink in for a minute. Why would he change it to the passenger side floorboard? That's where I was sitting. Why would they put a cigarette butt in my mac and cheese? Why would they greet me first? Hi, Mr. Cotter. She was the driver. Why are you even talking to me? I shouldn't even... A passenger didn't even have to identify himself. Legally. But I mean, they know who I am, so I'm, hey, hi, Mr. Carmen. Hi. Well, you know, what? I don't know. What am I supposed to do? I stay away from the car. I stay out of trouble. I stay away from the car. So now I gotta file a complaint. So would somebody help me? Because this is how my brain works. In 20 minutes, this is all I've been able to say to you. They're gonna get away with this, man. Like, if. And now, next time, what if they just stop me on the street and they find a. They find something on me to make me go away? They wanted me to go away in the video. I asked for it to be tested. I was threatened that I better just get the hell out of there. I need help. And the second thing I need help with, I have to write an apology letter to the Clintonville Police Department. So, if somebody could help me, you know, I will dictate, I'm not dictate, I will try to, and then hopefully we can distill this stuff that goes on in my head into something intelligible and hopefully prosecutable for sexual assault. But that's not the apology letter. See what I mean? I can't do this shit. So, the apology letter, I'm thinking of the things I'm sorry for. And it's very hard. Because this was gang harassment. This wasn't a police stop. And I've never apologized to a gang that harassed me before, sexually assaulted me and my girlfriend, and then to write them an apology. Like, I'm gonna file charges. So, watch me disappear off the face of this planet. I'm gonna get plucked up for some reason. I am. They're gonna find something, man. I'm scared to death. Okay, that's not the apology letter, see? The apology would consist of my language. That's it. If I could take anything back, it would be the language. The curse words specifically. But I am upset. And I think I'm legitimately upset. I'm legitimately upset about being held longer than we were supposed to. I'm legitimately upset about being lied to about the dog. I'm legitimately upset about not being told why the dog hit, where it is, what it is, what was the hit. And I'm legitimately upset about them lying about finding something. And then I'm legitimately upset about them lying to my PO. Legitimately. But if I could take anything back, it would be the curse. All those things could have been said by me without cussing, and I feel like I hurt my cause more than I helped it by doing that. And so for that, I am sorry. Now, this is due on Monday, tomorrow. I have tried all. I talked to her on Friday. I have tried ever since to write down stuff, and this is what it looks like. Okay, because I'm processing being sexually assaulted. I can't believe I have to apologize to people who sexually assaulted me and my girlfriend. But I have to. I gotta stay out. I gotta stay out of jail. I'm not too proud. I have people count on me, man. So if there's anything, it would be the language that I use. I'm sorry for the swear word. You know, but when they point a gun at your head and tell you to put your hands on your head, motherfucker, you don't have to apologize to them. Swearing isn't a crime. It's not even it's not a misdemeanor. It's not even a ticket. It's nothing. But maybe it's not polite. And Maybe I should have been more polite to the people who sexually assaulted me and my girlfriend and illegally stopped us and then gang harassed us. I should have. I need help. Somebody help me. Because I have to put this on paper by Monday morning. I'm gonna end up in jail.